Looks so simple, yet my class couldn't figure this out. Well, let me help you guys. We are going to calculate the limit as x approaching 1 of x over x minus 1. Whenever we are doing this kind of questions, we should always plug in this number into all the x's and see what happens. So when we do that, put 1 in here, we have 1 on the top, over, put 1 right here, we have 1, and then minus the 1 from the original question. All right. This is 1 over 1 minus 1, which is 0. The answer is not undefined. You cannot say that right away. You have to observe more. 1 over 0 is not one of the indeterminate forms here. In fact, you can draw a conclusion, but you have to do it carefully. This right here, you either get positive infinity or negative infinity. You just have to work out the sign. So let me just put this down, check the signs. So I will tell you what I mean by that. By the way, you never write down this being equal to plus or minus infinity. No, right? Okay, how do we do this though? Here's the key. This is the limit as x approaching 1 and there's no plus or minus. So we actually have to check both directions. First thing first, let's go ahead and maybe check the limit when x is approaching 1 from the right hand side first. So that's the 1 plus right here. Well, what do we do? Again, I will still put down this number into all the x's. So here we get 1 plus on the top over 1 plus and then minus 1. And you may be wondering what's 1 plus, right? On the top, I'll still keep it as 1 plus. Alright, now on the bottom, check this out. 1 minus 1, we know that's equal to 0, but if you have 1 plus here and then minus 1, this right here is 0 plus. It's a little bit confusing, so let's do this. Let's think about 1 plus as a number that's just a little bit bigger than 1. So we can look at 1 plus as 1.0001. How's that? So if you take a look right here and then minus 1, you see on the bottom, 1.0001 minus 1, which will get 0.0001. It's a number a little bit bigger than 0, so don't just write down 0, write down 0 plus. And the top right here is 1 plus, which is, as we said, it's like 1.0001. And now you have a number 1 on the top, 1.0001, divided by a very small number. What's the result? This right here will give us positive infinity. And in fact, right here, I should be using arrows because I'm technically doing limits. So let me fix that right here. So this limit is equal to infinity. And why do I put on the equal sign? Well, we are evaluating this limit and the limit is equal to infinity. When you do this, you should draw arrows as a way to show that you are taking a limit. Just notations. All right, let's do the other side, which is this right here. Let's take a look at the limit as x approaching 1, but from the negative direction, so we have a minus here. And then we have x over x minus 1. Go ahead and give it a try and let me know what you get first. Done? All right, you should get negative infinity here. Let's see. Put 1 minus into the x over, put 1 minus into this x, and then minus 1. Oops, again, arrows. Just being picky. All right, 1 minus is still 1 minus. Don't worry about that. The bottom, 1 minus 1 is 0. But here, we have 1 minus and then minus 1. This right here should be 0 minus. Now, why though? Again, just think about 1 minus as a number a little bit bigger than 1. A little bit smaller than 1. This right here, how about let's put it as 0.999. And then minus 1. You see this time, we will end up with a negative number, right? Negative 0.001. And that's what this negative is for. So as you can see, the bottom here, it's negative. But the top, even though you have 1 minus, this is, in fact, is still positive. Because this right here is like what? 0.999. As you said earlier, so the top is still positive. Now you have positive divided by negative. Again, check the signs. We get negative infinity. So this right here goes to negative infinity. And that will be for this right here. Now, to answer this question, after we have this and that, ask yourself, are they the same? No, they are not. These two limits are not equal. So the conclusion is, this original limit does not exist. All right? So hopefully this right here helps. Of course, this is more like a computational way to reason things out. If you would like to just graph this and then take a look when x is approaching 1, well, that will tell you the limit doesn't exist either. That's it.